I'm Adam Jones, EAS Product Line Manager with Viavi Solutions. And in this video, we're going to discuss how to ensure that your EASyCAP and EASyPlus systems are operational and ready for the upcoming National Periodic Test. The first item that we're going to discuss is the EASyCAP system. I highly recommend that you have your system upgraded to the current version of firmware before the national test. As of today, the current version of firmware is 3.04.03. For the EASyCAP system to be ready for the National Periodic Test, it's important to note that you should already be receiving alerts over your EAS radio inputs and from your FEMA IPAWS source, as the preferred method of receiving the national test will be through IPAWS. First, what you want to do is make sure that you have the NPT event code enabled. To do that, you go to the configuration menu and then to EAS events. And from there, you simply scan down to the National Periodic Test, highlight it, and ensure that it is enabled. If it is not, simply checkmark the box and hit accept. If your EASyCAP is running some very old versions of firmware, it's possible that you'll need to enable the national location code, as that is the FIPS code that will be sent for the national test. In the same configuration folder, simply scan down to selected locations, and you will have the option to checkmark a box that says enable the national location code here. If your particular firmware does not have that option, then it is already hard-coded and you're ready to go. Now, as I said before, it is important that you're already receiving events on your EASyCAP to ensure that you will properly receive the National Periodic Test. Now, your radio sources will vary from market to market, but you'll want to ensure that you're monitoring at least two sources. And you can do that by going to Configuration to the Audio and Radio Sources tab, and then selecting channels 1, 2, 3, all the way through 6, depending on your hardware configuration, and just ensuring that they're set up properly. The last thing that you can do to make sure that your FEMA source is being monitored properly is go to the Operations menu, select Alert Status, go to CAP Feed Status, and you should see successful polls. The last successful poll, hopefully, is very recently. It is not unusual to see failed polls, and it is also not unusual to see CAP messages not passing state filters. Since this is a national source, it is entirely possible that you will receive messages that aren't necessarily set up to be transmitted by your particular EASyCAP. In regards to failed polls, you simply do not want to have a very large number of those. You are polling a website, it is network dependent, and there are times that it will fail, but you do not want it to fail consistently. In this case, there is a significant difference in the number of successful polls to failed polls. Now, that concludes the proper setup for a National Periodic Test on your EASyCAP system. For the remainder of the video, we're going to take a look at the legacy EASyPlus, EASyCast, EASyIPTV platform. On this system, and keep in mind that this system is now end of life and will become obsolete on January 1st, 2019. But in regards to the National Periodic Test for this year, the system is still a very compliant system and will work for the test. Now, I do not have this particular hardware connected to my system, so we'll just go through the particular steps in ensuring that you are compliant. So after you've opened up your software, the first thing that you want to do is select, if applicable, the appropriate EASyPlus, EASyCast, or EASyIPTV hardware you're wanting to connect to, and then select Retrieve Configuration. After you have successfully retrieved your configuration, you'll want to go to the Events tab first. And just like on your EASyCAP, or how we discussed on the EASyCAP, you'll scroll down to the National Periodic Test and ensure that it is enabled. If it's not, you can double-click on the event, checkmark Enable. The other thing that you want to do is go to the General tab, ensure that you have Enable CAP Alerts checked. This would be important if you're using our Windows software or our EASyCAP server for sending your platform CAP Alerts, and also that the National Location Code is enabled. Now it's important that if any of these items were not checked or were not enabled, that you need to go to the Main tab and select Program Configuration. Keep in mind the platform that you're using was designed over 20 years ago and is not live to the system. So the software requires that you pull information and push information back to the hardware that you're working with. Now the last thing that's important on both platforms is to ensure that your time of day is accurate on your hardware. On the EasyPlus side, the only thing that you need to do is hit Set Time. And what it will do is it will set the time to the EasyPlus as is on your local computer, the computer that you're using the software on. It does not change the time zone, it simply changes the time. And so your time zone is referenced in the General tab under System Settings. So you'll just want to make sure that that's correct. Again, any changes that you make, just ensure that you hit Program Configuration. Going back to your EasyCAP, time is checked and set on the date and time menu under the configuration folder. This will reflect the date and time that is currently on the unit. If you need to set the time, you would simply select the appropriate date, time, hit set time, and closed. On this platform, I highly recommend the use of a time server. And that concludes the setup and configuration to ensure that your hardware is ready for the National Periodic Test. If you have any more questions, please reach out to our support department.